Hello everyone, welcome back to the Music Ball. My name is Joe and I'm back with not a reaction video. I guess we'll say it's recap, you know, chit chat, all that stuff. I'm noticing my lights aren't on. Hold on. Ooh, magic. There we go. You like that? It's magic, my love. Anyway, so yeah, I'm back here to talk about, let's talk Vegas. Oh my God, I am so excited. And there's going to be a lot of rambling. I think this is more like a podcast kind of video. So please follow the sound of my voice as I talk to you about Vegas weekend with the one and only icon, Queen Miss Kelly Clarkson. So to give you guys context, Kelly Clarkson, the one and only, the true American Idol. She is doing her residency right now in Vegas, 10 shows at the once known Zappos Theater, Planet Hollywood Theater. I don't know how you pronounce it right now. So in that theater from July 28th all the way to August 19th. And so it's 10 shows. And I was very lucky and blessed and thankful to go to opening night, which was July 28th. So Vegas, I mean, honestly, it was my first time going to Vegas as, you know, older than 21. So it was such an experience, first of all, kind of like an express trip. It landed on Thursday night and then, you know, got back to Tijuana on Saturday night. So it was really just to go see the show. And it was a treat myself kind of trip. It's like, okay, you know, the school year is done, teaching, singing, you know, all that stuff. I've saved my money. I'm on a budget still, but I'm going to treat myself to this trip, right? So opening night, July 28th, got there at around 6 o'clock, actually. Doors open at 6:30. I heard it was a lot of confusion about like the beat the line, the VIP people, the premiums and all that stuff. I was, you know, regular, a mortal, a muggle, if you want to say. That's a Harry Potter reference. So I had my reserve seat, section 203 was my section. And so I got there, but I wanted to get there early to see the merch and to, you know, just cozy up, right? So got there and everything, and I was able to make line. So what I bought for merch, actually, I'll get to all that. No, actually, I'll just get it out of the way right now so that we can talk about the show afterwards. Okay, so what I bought was the tour book, the program. Okay, this is stunning, okay? Side note, the tag said it was $25, and it's actually $35. So if you're planning to buy this, just, you know, watch out. It is actually $35, unless they lower the price for whatever reason. So it's so beautiful, you guys. So it's basically, you know, it's a little tour book. They have photos of Kelly, you know, through the years and everything. It's a beautiful message. The last 20 years have been incredible. Thank you so much for supporting me, singing with me, and growing up with me. Here's to another 20 years. Love, Kelly. And it's so stunning. So I bought that. And then I was able to go to my seat. Honestly, if you're wondering, like, oh, what section works? Like, what seats should I get? Like, I'm on a budget, whatever. Guys, literally every seat in the house is amazing. Like the view, there's no bad seat. Like really every seat is you're going to just have a blast and you'll be able to see everything. I got there and everything. I was seated with some fans and everything. A lovely couple from Minnesota. They were celebrating a birthday, if I'm not mistaken. And they were like, it was their first time seeing Kelly. And I was so excited for them. And it was like, oh, just great. Super, super fun. And just to be able to enjoy that moment with them. And there were some other fans next to me in the back. Like it was a fan section. And I will say, because a lot of people think like, oh, Vegas shows, like it's going to be the general audience, which there were some people that were just there to see a Vegas show. But for opening night, there was so many like fans, like everything. And I'll get to that part of the show. I'm just about to start talking about it. Oh, by the way, Kelly was everywhere in Vegas. Like I saw so much promo and like posters and everything, including my hotel. They had this magazine. I mean, it was in the lobby, guys. So I grabbed a copy. I was like, I'm going to keep it. And it's lovely. It's a wonderful article that they do about the Vegas show. And they talk about chemistry. They highlight Skip This Part, which I was very happy about because that's one of the best songs in the album. So all I have to say, side note. Okay, let's get to the show. So the big question everyone had in mind was what song is going to be the first one? I thought she was going to start with Skip This Part because it's like, I don't know. I thought it was going to be like that kind of very deep moment in the opening and then like get to like the like big hits, you know? Like I thought that was going to happen. But no, she opened this show with spoiler alert, by the way. If anyone has not gone to Vegas yet and you don't want to hear about the set list, you might want to pause this video now and check it out later, unless you want to hear. I mean, you probably have seen videos as well. Anyway, so first song, opening track, favorite kind of high. I actually thought it was a great opening for the show. Super fun. I love that everyone, like the crowd was so into it. And favorite kind of needs to be a single. Like, what are we doing? I know the strike, you know, it stopped everything, you know, the promo stuff, but at least send it to radio. This is a great track and it has so much potential. I love favorite kind of high, and I thought it was a great opening. And just she seems like her vibe, like she was so just you could tell like she was so happy to be back on stage. Like it was everything. So favorite kind of high, then we get to classics, Hazel Eyes and My Life Is Stuck Without You with the next two songs. And she, I mean, here's the thing. In between the show, like in the moments that she would talk, you could tell like she was taking everything in. Like it was a take it all in kind of moment for her because the fans, the crowd, the audience was everything that day. Like we were singing along to every track, with the exception of one, which I'll get to, but for obvious reasons. And but just cheering her on, just being with her, she got emotional at times, and it was such a wonderful experience. And I think like she felt it, and it was great. It was really so happy. I, as a fan, I was so happy to see her just recognizing that she's being celebrated, if that makes sense. Like she could feel, she knows that she has a loyal fan base, but I don't think she got it. I don't think she realized, like, yeah, girl, we bought chemistry, we know the songs, we are going to sing along with you, and we're going to share this moment with you, and we're going to make you feel like the queen that you are, you know, give you your flowers as you rightfully deserve. Anyway, so that big segue and all that stuff. So how the set list works is there are going to be some songs that are going to be rotating. And it'll be different every show, which is very awesome, you know. So the big question will always be like, okay, if I'm going to the August 2nd show, what songs am I gonna get that everyone else didn't? Okay. So that was a big thing. So we got for opening night, one of the songs was Broken and Beautiful from the Ugly Doll soundtrack. She said that she loved pink and everything. Here's the thing. I know some fans were like not feeling and don't feel Broken and Beautiful. I really like that song. I think it has a very strong message and it's really cute. Would I prefer another song maybe from Chemistry? Yes. But I was happy that we got it. And then we had this very cute moment. Someone threw a Moxie doll at her. Obviously asking her, like, can I throw this to you? Because do not throw things at artists, okay? And she made that clear. She's like, if you're gonna throw something at me, throw diamonds, which was hilarious. But we had this cute moment and I actually took a photo of it, her holding a Moxie doll, and it's just so pretty. So we had that special moment for opening night. So that was cute. Then we had to a section of karaoke. That's really cool. Obviously, they brought that from the talk show, and she did "As It Was" by Harry Styles. Honestly, here's the thing: I like Harry Styles, but that's not my favorite song of his. So I was like, okay, she sang great, but I was like, I could do without this one. You know, I would have preferred, you know, "Fake Plastic Trees" or "Call Out My Name" or "Blue Bayou" or oh my God, if she had done "Queen of the Night," if she does "Queen of the Night," okay, whatever. So we got that. Then we get to the first track from Chemistry that at the time was going to be rotating. Now apparently it's going to be a staple, and that's Lighthouse. I was so happy that we got this track on opening night because it's so special. That's my favorite song of the album. So I was very happy that she sang it, and you could feel like it's just. It's a wonderful thing. And the crowd was there with her. I will say about like the audience, most of us were standing up the entire time. You know, like I don't think there was only one song that I got to sit that I actually chose to sit, and I'll get to that in a moment. But just like the energy every time a chemistry song would come out, the energy that every time a new song from chemistry would play or start being performed was everything. And I think that's why Kelly was so surprised, because like, oh, it's new material, but like, girl, this album is amazing. Give yourself the opportunity to do every song, which she is going to do. So Lighthouse was simply fantastic. After Lighthouse, which was such a beautiful moment, one of the highlights of the show for me, we got Catch My Breath, which I was so excited for. I love Catch My Breath. I mean, that's a Casey classic right there. And we haven't heard that song in a while, actually. So I was very happy that she did it. The crowd was into it and all that stuff. That's a really great track. Then we get to Because of You, which is always a highlight. One of those hits that you know the song's gonna be played, but it's still a very special moment in the show. And I love the arrangement they did a little bit different this time, which was very, very nice. And can I just say, as a side note, the band, oh my God, the band, it was, I mean, we've talked about Jason Halbert, musical director, Avin, Jocko, Lester. Shout out to Todd Collins, by the way, because he's one of the percussionists. Ken Reed, okay, Ken is the bass player right now. And then we have Raymond, Jesse, and Garrett, the horn section, which were fabulous. And then literally, let's talk about the vocalist, background vocals. So we have Allison from Idol. I think she was in season 8. I was so happy to see her, to see her just shine and everything. We also have Charlotte, who I'll get to that, but we sort of met her after the show. And then Jesse, of course, was amazing. And Aaron, who's also fantastic. Like the harmonies, yo, these vocalists, they are everything. Kelly's team, Kelly's band, y'all, is everything. Anyway, so Because of You was such a highlight, I really enjoyed it. And then it's so interesting. After Because of You, we have that moment, the special moment. And then we have this moment of like gospel. The organ, and I'm like, oh my God, is it me? Not is it me, like the song. And buried myself into somebody else. And everyone's like, yes. It was such a moment on the show. She was like feeling it. And there's moments where it's like standing next to me and like pumping her chest and just being in the moment, that high note. Everything. It was everything, and the crowd lost it, and it was just a great time. So Me was fabulous. She does Breakaway, which was cute. Everyone was singing along, and Kelly does a thing on in between the stage. I don't want to spoil that much, but you'll know if you see videos. But then we go to like a more intimate setting with these next three songs, and I was so happy she did Love So Soft. I love this song. This is one of my favorites, my favorites, my favorites. I'm so happy I got to hear it live. I didn't get to see the Meaning of Life tour, so I was very happy that she did a song from that album, especially that one. Then we went to Walk Away, which is always a classic, and I know some people are like, "Eh, about Walk Away." It's one of my favorites from Kelly's catalog, and you can tell like it's one of her favorites, and the arrangement that they do is so fun. I love Walk Away. It's just super, super great. How they really give it that like more soulful vibe to the track. It's everything. And then we get to Remy's favorite track, which I think is hilarious, but I live for this whole lot of woman, and I was so happy that she did it. Because it should have been a single. But that's another story. And it's obviously fantastic. And there was a lyric change because obviously it says, I reside in Tennessee, but now it's I reside in NYC, and which I thought was super clever and super fun. So, Whole Lotta Woman was great. Then we get to the next section with Red Flag Collector. Shout out to Other Kelly. Emily and Jonathan, they were whole that well, I knew maybe some people were as well, but I know they were handing out red flags. Oh my God. Okay, I got this one after the show, but I knew that some people like had them for a reason. I'm like, where are we getting this? And I thought they were selling them, but no, like at the merch table, but no. I found us out later. So the intro for Red Flag Collector starts, and I just see like all these little red flags like started to come up. I'm like, this is such a moment. This is why Kelly Clarkson fans are the best, okay? Because we really like it's such a special moment, and you can tell the band was surprised by it, and Kelly was surprised by it, and they lived for it. And just I love Red Flag Collector. It's super, super fun live and everything. I know that I said that it was like the one that I was not vibing to the most after hearing the full album, but that was only because I had overplayed it when it was released. But now I'm back to listening and enjoying it again. Then we get to another Casey classic, I believe, and this is Meaning of Life. Oh my God, she gives so much love to Meaning of Life, which I am so happy for because that's such a great album. And I was so happy she did this one because it's When You Kiss Me, I Know Who I Am. It's just such a great track. Again, soulful. Like, that's Meaning of Life was the album that like Kelly was so happy to make at the time. And it's just, there's so much, there's such an energy and a vibe. Like, she's enjoying it. And people were vibing to it as well and really paying attention. But then we get to this next song, which I personally think was the highlight of the show for me. And it's a song called Tightrope. And Tightrope is a song from Piece by Piece, which was released in 2015. Now, if you've heard the album version, then you're like, okay, it's a cute song. But I remember listening to it when I went to see her live during the Piece by Piece tour in 2015. And this song was such a special moment. And it added so much emotion and rawness to it that we don't hear on the album. The live version really makes it happen for me. And so when that version was released in the remixed little album that they did during the Idol Piece by Piece performance, I was very happy that they did because it just adds new life to it. So I was very excited to hear the song live. And again, with many of these songs, knowing what happened, you know, in Kelly and her personal life and everything, and it really hit. And I think so many people were just like, oh my God, you could hear a pin drop in this song because everyone was so quiet. This is probably the only time in the show where everyone was just like silence, just listening to her and feeling her emotions and the rawness of everything that she went through and just the lyrics. And you and I will fall in time eventually. And maybe we'll both die trying. And I ain't seen nothing like you. Like, just, and I, like, she had a moment after the song saying, like, if you, or before, like, you think my ex would have heard the song and be like, ooh, you know? So, which gives us more perspective of, like, stuff was happening even when we thought, like, they were the happiest couple alive, you know? So it was, which obviously, like, you never know what happens behind closed doors, right? So it's a long thing. But seeing Kelly so vulnerable and so raw with her emotions, with her fans, like, that's why we feel like that connection with her, because it's like she really is sharing everything with us, and we're there, like, we got you, girl. You know, we really do. So it was a great time. But interesting, after that, we get Mine, which was another great moment in the show. And I mentioned this in the, when I reacted to it the first time, I said that, go ahead and break my heart, that's fine. That part was going to be this stadium-like effect where everyone was going to sing along. And it was, like, it was so amazing to hear the crowd sing along. And Kelly was surprised by it. And she had a moment after the song being like, the fact that, I'm paraphrasing, obviously, the fact that I went through something really hard and I get to connect. It's connecting with people. It's such a cool thing. Thank you so much. And we're like, yes. Like, guys, Vegas is such a cool thing. Like, it was such a wonderful opening night. Interesting segue to the next song, which was Heartbeat Song, where we had that, those two emotions, Tightrope and Mine, and then we get to This Is My Heartbeat Song. Interesting segue, but I don't hate it. Now, I will say, a lot of people, I know that fans are iffy about Heartbeat Song. It's really fun live, you know, and I was feeling it. And the crowd, the people that were in my section, we were feeling it as well, singing along with her. It's a fun song live, honestly. But the next one is one that this was like a question mark for me. This was the only part of the show that was like, there's something about Invincible, and I don't know what it is. But when she said that she was going to play this one, like, oh, it's one of my favorites and everything. It's like, this is Invincible. I'm like, oh, I loved hearing it. She sounded amazing. But I was like, I feel like there were so many other songs that could have fit there, especially pre-encore, you know? Maybe Heat, because it was after Heartbeat Song. I don't know, like a Breakaway track or My December. There was no love for My December on opening night, which I was very surprised about. I don't know. Any other track I feel. Invincible is fine, but it just didn't do it for me. The song, her, stunning. Amazing. And then we get to the encore, and of course we have the three big hits. Miss Independent, which still is such a bop after 20 years. Like, it's a great song. You could tell that she loves singing it, and the crowd was into it as well. And then, of course, we get Stronger, which was obviously a big anthem. And then Since You've Been Gone, right? So we get the hits. It was honestly a really, really fun show. The production was very simple. It was very intimate. It fits the intimate vibe because it's a screen, obviously, where we can see her and the band and everything like up close. And then we have the lighting production. And then we have the band like in with a few platforms. And that's it. Like, that's all the production that there is. And I think it fits. It fits wonderful. And again, Kelly has always been, you know, all about the simplicity of the production. Yes, going a little bit, I don't want to say over the top, but doing a little bit more, especially with Meaning of Life and Piece by Piece. Like, those were really massive productions. But I feel like this time it fit with the intimate experience, I guess we'll say. So, yeah, all in all, it was a really, really good show. Kelly's voice, she sounds better than ever. Like, it's just insane how amazing she sounds and how effortless it is for her to sing all these tracks. It's just fantastic. And I was so happy to just have that moment. I will say, another highlight for me was meeting so many amazing people before and after the show. Here's the thing. I've always been a Kelly Clarkson fan, stan, you know, all that stuff. But I've never been like as involved in the community as I have been in the last 2 years, especially since I started doing these reaction videos. Interacting with so many Kelly Clarkson fans during these last 2 years, and then like Vegas is happening. It's like, okay, I'm going to Vegas, and I saw people like, I'm going too, and opening night, and oh my god, so exciting, and all that stuff, and actually meeting them now in person. Like, it was such a moment, and I met so many amazing, amazing people during the Vegas show and then the day after, and I'm so blessed. Now let's get to stories, because so many things happened. So obviously I saw some fans, and we caught up, and it was like, oh my god, what section are you in, and everything. We said hi and all that stuff. So after the show, caught up with some fans, that some fellow Casey fans who are now friends, and went to Hard Bar, which is right there, Planet Hollywood. And so I remember it was Rochelle, and then Emily and Jonathan were there. Sabrina, which, by the way, Sabrina was the girl that had the hall pass poster. Shout out to you, girl. Just highlight of the night. It really was. Sabrina and Megan was there as well. Liz from San Diego, shout out to you, girl. And then other Kelly and Diane, they were also there. Who else am I missing? Oh my god, I'm missing so many people, I'm sure. Also, I got to see someone who I adore, and I love his reaction videos, and he's so kind and so sweet. Topher from Topher Reacts. If you don't know who he is, check out his videos. I'm gonna put the link in the description, because it was just great. It was great to see everyone, and exactly like who I thought they would be. So kind and so chill and so awesome. So yeah. But there was so many great fans. So we were there at the Heart Bar, and it was so much fun. And then we were like, oh my god, who's behind us? And it was Kelly's band. they were behind us on another couch. And I was like, oh my God, they're right here. So it was everything. So it was, we're like, I'm trying to be like discreet and just be like, oh my God, it's them. Like, I want to say hi, but I don't know how. I like a picture or whatever. And so Robert Ramos, fabulous. He's the first one, like, we make eye contact, and it's like, hello. And he goes, you're Joe, right? I said, what? You know who I am? Like, it was such a moment. He's like, and that's the thing, like, I'm aware, like, Kelly's team, they know probably who, like, some of us fans are, because we comment, and we share, and we talk about it, and all that stuff, like, all things Kelly, right? But it was such a moment, and it was like, hi, nice to meet you. And so I said hi to Robert. Then it was Candace and Natasha, the glam squad, fashion squad, all three of them. And it was, but it was so, because Candace said, hi, oh my God, because he's saying hi to everyone, like, I'm Candace. And I was like, oh my God. And then I stayed silent because I was starstruck. And I'm sure it was so embarrassing. So, but everyone was so nice, and we hugged, and then Avon gave me a huge, like, oh my God, hi, how are you? And gave me a huge hug. And it was like, what is happening right now? Like, what a moment this is. And then we talked to Jesse a little bit, like, some of us, and just fantastic. Who else? Oh my God. I feel like everyone was there. Just a really magical time, and it was great. But that, it doesn't stop there, guys. Then we get to Saturday. So big shout out and love to the Miss Indepodcast, Jeremy and Pam, these two people who are just icons and are so fabulous. So they were there on opening night, and they decided to do like this live episode recording and everything in a room, conference hall, we'll say, and the conference center there in Planet Hollywood. So a bunch of us like bought tickets and everything. And so it was wonderful. And I have, thank you, Pam. She let me take one of these. So this is my, I guess, the evidence that I was there. So it was just wonderful to see like so many amazing, amazing people again, like, and catching up to more people that I'd seen the previous night, and people that I saw there for the first time. Meaning, for example, Seth, who also is the Casey Balt, who really, I mean, we owe him so much because all those videos in HD are of vintage classic Kelly and all that stuff is fantastic. So he's doing the Lord's work. So David, Dan as well. Who else did I see that was like, and it was so sweet, like people coming up to me and be like, oh my God, are you Joe? Like from the reaction videos. And it was so cool to be like, okay, identifying like, oh, you're this person, or you're from this username, or stuff like that. It's just magical. But anyway, missing the podcast. It was so much fun, with Jeremy and Pam, and then Rob, obviously fashion correspondent Rob, just giving us iconic moments. And then they did like a game show thing, which, by the way, I'm just going to say right now, I'm throwing this out there, Jeremy and Pam, it's in a podcast. If you ever do a game of throw me a line and sing along, I am there, okay? Just putting it out there in the universe, okay? I want to do it. So, okay. That was a highlight for me for this weekend. Just getting the opportunity to meet so many amazing Kelly fans and who are now considered friends to me. Like, they were all so adorable and so sweet and friendly and kind. And that, I think that's the Kelly fan base. Like, it's such a community of love and support. I mean, I'm sure we have our disagreements about songs or whatever, but it was just a great time. It really, really was. Now we get to you guys enjoying a little bit of some clips of the show, with including myself singing maybe one or two songs. So here's a little clip. Roll it.
Thank you.
And also, it was so much fun because obviously, like, I on Saturday had a lot of time for my flight because I couldn't stay for the second night. I wanted to, but you know, I had already set up my plans and everything. So I ended up, you know, as I said, I went to lunch with some fellow Casey friends, and then eventually they all started making line for the second show. So I was like, I'll just hang out here with you guys. So I was there, Pam was there, and Jeremy again, and then Jordan and Adam, who I also saw, and Christy, she's from the UK, which I love her. She was so adorable. And then everyone was there and just chit-chatting and all that stuff. And it was so much fun. And just it was a great, great weekend. It really was. So, but if I forgot something, let me know in the comments. Let me know if you were there on opening night or if you're there on Saturday, or if you're going to the show, what are you expecting, et cetera, et cetera. There's so many things, but for now I'm going to say thank you so much for watching, and hopefully you enjoyed my rambling and talking about this show. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe and hit like, and I'll see you back for the next video. Bye-bye.